Good morning. And welcome. I'm Father Dennis Thompson. I'm honored to be here to celebrate Chuck's life. And let us stand together. Let us come together in faith. My brothers and sisters, praise be God. Praise be God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercy, and the God of all consolation. It is Jesus who comes to comfort us in our affliction, in our sorrow, and thus enables us to comfort those who are in trouble with the same consolation we have received from Him. I bless the remains of Charles with holy water, which he calls his first entrance to our church, his baptism, in the Father, the Son, the Spirit. Amen. All of us who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death. By baptism into his death, we were buried together with him. So just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him by likeness to his death, so shall we be united with him by likeness to his resurrection. And on the day of Charles' baptism, he put on Christ as we put on this white cloth, a symbol of the white garment he received. In the day of Christ's coming, may Chuck be clothed with glory. Amen. This time I'd like to invite Dan to come forward to give a eulogy. Thank you, Dan. Please be seated.
Six-word tune in the bathroom every morning, and for the past week, I've been hearing it in my head, I hope. Today, we're here to celebrate the life and mourn the loss of my father, Chuck Lynch. Father, grandfather, great-grandfather, brother, uncle, sponsor, mentor, friend, philanthropist, adventurer, and comedian. There are two watershed events that shaped his life. The first was in 1972 when, under acrimonious circumstances, he left the business of his father and started his own company. He vowed that he would not repeat what he saw as the errors of his father, and so years later, he stepped back and he gifted the company he had created to his children. We come to parenthood with the tools that our parents gave us. Chuck worked hard to improve on those skills, and through self-reflection and a lifetime of mentoring and supporting everyone he came in contact with, determined to improve the lives of others. The second most profound event of his life was his recovery from alcoholism through Alcoholics Anonymous in 1982. It was through his recovery he reached out and touched the lives of innumerable people, more than we will ever know. Chuck's older brother, Larry, had died of alcoholism in 1971. And Uncle Chuck was then a constant presence in the lives of my cousins, Nancy, Katie, Molly, and David. In their own words, providing guidance, support, and encouragement in the face of life's challenges. David told me how Uncle Chuck was the inspiration for his learning Chinese and how he had led him to his 20-year career in Asia. My dad had an insatiable interest in Asia for decades. I remember him sitting in the living room studying Chinese and listening to Chinese language on cassette tapes. He would take the family to Howard Wong's in 494 for Chinese dinner and encourage us to eat with chopsticks. When I finished my education, I said I wanted to go to Europe to write. He said, "Oh, don't go there. Europe is so old hat. Go to Asia." So I went to Hong Kong, and 2 months later, he showed up to meet me. After a couple of weeks traveling through Taiwan and the Philippines, he said, "You should go home." I remember standing in the hotel room in Hong Kong, and I told him, "No, I'm not going home. I'm moving to Thailand." I think back on that moment now and remember that he was partly dismayed and partly impressed. "Be careful," he said, "it's the Wild East over there." Two nights ago, my siblings and I had dinner together and talked about our adventures with our father. He loved Asia and he loved showing people around. He loved making jokes. Sometimes, I think he liked those jokes better when he knew they wouldn't be understood. Nobody understood the knock-knock jokes in Asia. And he would laugh until he almost fell over. But the real driving force of his life was helping people recover from alcoholism and drug addiction. During the past 10 days, I have received several very personal stories of how Chuck took people to meetings and in many cases paid for their treatment. I heard from someone named Jackie who told me about taking tango lessons with him in Playa del Carmen. He took her to meetings and paid for her treatment at Hazleton. Jackie got sober in 1998. I heard from Marcel Schmidt, who Chuck had helped get sober in Playa. Marcel, Chuck, and Chuck's best friend, Bill Rasmussen, traveled around Central America together. At one point, they drove into a village in Honduras and asked a group of local kids why they weren't in school. The kids didn't have money to attend school. Chuck and Bill paid for their education for years. My dad made my own recovery possible. Not by pushing, but by leading by example. In 1988, I got sober in Bangkok because of his example. 2 years ago, in 2018, he gave me my 30-year AA medallion. Dad lived a rich life, filled with adventure, joy, and laughter. He was always curious in learning. He always wanted to know what everyone in the extended family was up to, who was traveling where and learning what. Life was an adventure. His grandchildren were extremely important to him. He contributed to their college funds and wanted to spend time with them and know what was happening in their lives. In reflecting on the life of my father, I realized that what matters most in life is not what we get, but how we can contribute to the lives of others.
My brothers and sisters, let us stand together. We gather in faith, hope, and love, and so we begin in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. My brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Indeed, we know the Lord is here with us as we mourn the loss of Chuck. And so we say and we pray. O God, to whom all mercy and all forgiveness belong, hear our prayers on behalf of your servant, Chuck, whom we have called from this world, because he put his faith, hope, and trust in the Lord. Command that he be carried safely home to heaven to enjoy your eternal reward. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. I invite you now to be seated for the proclamation of God's word and may your first blessing as he comes forward.
There is an appointed time for everything, and a time for every affair under the heavens, a time to give birth and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to uproot the plant, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to tear down and a time to build, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to scatter stones and a time to gather them. A time to embrace and a time to be far from embraces. A time to seek and a time to lose. A time to keep and a time to cast away. A time to rend and a time to sow. A time to be silent and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time of war and a time of peace. God has made everything appropriate to its time.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In green pastures he makes me lie down. Beside restful waters he leads me. He refreshes my soul. He guides me along right paths for his name's sake. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil. For you are with me, with your rod and your staff that give me courage. You set the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Indeed, goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come. Psalm 23. And now, if you would stand for the gospel. Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia.
I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. He who believes in me will not die forever. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia.
My brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Now when Jesus saw the large crowds, he went up the mountain. And after he had sat down, he gathered his disciples around him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. And blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. And blessed are they who hunger and thirst for what is right. They will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will be able to see God. And blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called the children of God. And blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. And blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward in heaven will be great. The gospel of our Lord. Praise you, Lord Jesus. Good morning. Please be seated. Welcome. I'm Father Dennis Thompson. I've been helping out here at St. Stan's. No one can ever replace Father John Clay, but in the passing of Chuck, I've heard from so many parishioners wonderful stories about him. A wonderful parishioner. Someone who was well loved and respected in this community. I only wish that I had known him. As Dan spoke about his life, his adventures, he lived a very rich life. 86 years. 86 years. It is a short time. We mourn his passing. But today we all come here to celebrate his life, to carry on his legacy, his gift. Chuck's life is a celebration. As I began rooted in faith, hope, and love. That is truly all that matters. Faith, hope for the future, and love. Our first reading tells us there is a time for everything under heaven. Time for everything good and bad. In 86 years, Chuck endured many things throughout his life, being in the army, his work, helping out others, truly a minister, someone who brought life, ministering through AA, through his own brokenness, helping others to find healing. A time for everything. Life demands faith. We need faith to understand our life, any good and bad that happens, and that makes up all of our lives. But time goes by so fast. 86 years. Just think of the many people he touched, who he helped, who he made a difference. A life well lived, but more importantly, a life well loved. And you know that, a life well loved. And that makes all the difference. Faithfulness to God, his parish, his family, his friends, his work. Faithfulness is what the Lord calls us to, each and every one of us, all the time of our life. Lord has never called us to be successful. That doesn't matter. But faithful in all that we do. And if we are faithful, we are truly very successful. Remember in a Bob Dylan song, Love My Hysteria, he writes, there's no success like failure. And failure's no success at all. I'm sure Chuck realized that in his own work with AA made him successful. If we are faithful, we are very successful. His dedication, his ministry, and the message of the gospel today, and Chuck's life tells us this, it's a gift to be simple. We don't need a lot in life. It's not what we have that makes us successful, but what we truly give away. Very simply, love is the only thing we take with us when we go, and it's really the only thing that we ever leave behind. Nothing else just so. When Chuck left us, he took the love of his family and friends and leaves that legacy, a gift. And that's what we celebrate, that legacy. Let us remain treasured in the simple gift of love. It is the only thing that truly matters. I'd like to conclude with a prayer. You know, words fail. It's all about presence, you being here. Your presence. Words fail. Prayer always succeeds. May the peaceful happiness that flows from God be with you on this day of loss. For God has given you much to do, many to love, and a heaven to hope for. May you find comfort today from your pain, your loss, your sorrow. May you spend this day reflecting on what God has done, the love God shares with us, and the future that is ours in the Lord. And so we thank God for the life of Chuck. There is a time for everything. Now Chuck belongs to the Lord, and God has given him eternity. And he has placed eternity in our heart. That is love. Carry your relative, your neighbor, your friend in your heart. That is where he resides. When Chuck's earthly journey was complete, Almighty God opened wide the gates of heaven, threw out his arms and said, "Well done, good and faithful servant. Welcome home." And so we give praise to God for his life. Let us stand together now, knowing it is the love of the Lord that gathers us here, mindful of his presence. Let us pray now for the needs of our church, the needs of Chuck's family, his friends.
For Chuck, when baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that he may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of Chuck, that they will find comfort in being loved by God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all deceased members of our families who are in the loving arms of God, especially those who welcomed her, Marge, Larry, Greg, Mary Alice, Pat, and Denny. Into heaven, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Most high and glorious God, we ask that you enlighten our hearts and our minds in this time of loss, that you instill in each one of us a correct faith, a certain hope, and a perfect love, a sense of knowledge, Lord, so that we may always do your will in our lives. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I invite you now to be seated for the offertory.
Throughout the
Take this, all of you,
and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death until you come again. My brothers and sisters, it is the love and mercy of the Lord that has gathered us here to celebrate this mystery, this memorial of his death and resurrection. And so we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving you thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and to minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity together with our Holy Father, Pope Francis, with our Archbishop Bernard, with all the bishops and the clergy, and the entire people your son has gained for you. Lord, remember your servant, Chuck, whom you've called from this world to your son. Grant that he, who was united with your son in a death like his, may also be one with him now in his resurrection. Lord, remember all of our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your presence. Have mercy on us, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints and martyrs who have pleased you throughout all the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to you and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Cure him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit. All glory and honor is yours, O Father, forever and ever. Amen. United in our brother, let us pray in the words Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. We pray, Lord, that you deliver us from every evil, and graciously grant to us peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ, for the kingdom, the power, and the glory of the universe. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, your friends, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Lord, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The peace, O Lord, be with you always. Let's offer that peace to you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ bring us joy. Just a reminder, during this COVID time, communion is offered at the very end for those who would like to receive to come forward and receive communion for those who will be leaving and go on either side of the door. Let's be seated.
Death is nothing at all. I have only slipped away to the next room. I am I, and you are you. Whatever we were to each other, that we still are. Call me by my old familiar name. Speak to me in the easy way which you always use. Put no difference into your tone. Wear no forced air of solemnity or sorrow. Laugh as we always laughed at the little jokes we enjoyed together. Play, smile, think of me, pray for me. Let my name be ever the household word that it always was. Let it be spoken without effect, without the trace of a shadow on it. Life means all that it ever meant. It is the same that it ever was. There is absolute unbroken continuity. Why should I be out of mind just because I'm out of sight? I am but waiting for you, for an interval, somewhere very near, just around the corner. All is well with me. Let all be well with you until we meet again. And now, in remembrance of Chuck, how about we all join together and say the little prayer that I'm sure he dedicated his whole life to. God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, the courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. And I'm sure that he went to heaven saying that prayer. And now I would like to make an announcement that anyone who is not going to the cemetery is welcome to go to Dan's home, where lunch will be served up there, and then there will be people there so that you can go in and visit and wait until the people come back from the cemetery. Wait a minute, I gotta grab the end. Okay, Dan lives at 2476 Edgecombe Road. And I don't have the directions, but if you stick it in your GPS, they'll get you there. So God bless all of you, and we are going to truly miss Chuck at St. Stan's. He was just the most lovely man, and he was always so friendly. And I'll tell you, he is missed, as I'm sure all of you will miss him too. Thank you.
My brothers and sisters, let us stand here. We have gathered here trusting in God, and we have prayed together for Chuck. Now our Christian community comes to the last ceremony. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Chuck again and enjoy his friendship. Although we will disperse in sorrow, it is the mercy of God that will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another with faith of our Lord Jesus Christ. And so into your loving hands, Father of mercy, we commend our brother Chuck in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us to remain to comfort one another with the assurance of our faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with Chuck forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord is with you. And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Let us go now to carry out the legacy of Chuck. Thanks be to God. I thought the big part was going to be playing here.